Clipper TV.
Don't forget it,
Clipper TV.
Don't you sweat it,
cause we got all your news
and a few interviews,
cause it's Clipper,
Clipper TV.
Welcome back, YHS. This is Clipper TV, and we're excited for another fun year. It's been a while, but we're back and ready for everything.
Welcome back, YHS. It's been quite the break since our last Clipper TV. It's
been a minute. But we're back now.
Yes.
Ready to go.
I reckon.
So, Isaac, the last Clipper TV episode was when we were freshmen. How would you say your high school experience has been since then?
Well, I'll tell you, Audrey, it's quite the long road.
Yeah. We made it this far.
No.
What's your opinion on the lack of female directors nominated for Oscars this year?
Well, I tell you, I haven't seen... There's probably 90% of all the movies that people are talking about I haven't seen, so I can't really say anything about it. Mm-hmm. But I'd like to have a shout-out to my queen, Natalie Portman. She deserves nothing.
She presented with Timothée Chalamet.
Huh?
At the Oscars, she presented with Timothée Chalamet.
Who's that? Natalie Portman. So, a winter sports update, you know, a lot of people are going to their playoff season.
Yeah.
But I think first we should talk about the biggest sporting event, probably the year, actually.
Yeah. No, of whole 2020.
2020.
Yeah.
So, I'm just going to come out and say it. Who do you think is going to win?
It'll be a good fight.
So, yeah, I think is going to win because he's going to absolutely pummel him. He's going to destroy him. He's like one punch
out.
He's going to, but yeah, I don't think he has self-control to not keep going. He's going to be on the ground, he's going boom, boom. It's going to be crazy.
Let's go to Adriana to hear about some winter sports update.
Hello, I'm Adriana Whitlock, and I'm here with Keely McConville. Keely, what's one word that describes your swim season?
Over.
Over. That reminds me of
my drug-free life was over. When I got my wisdom teeth out.
Let's look at that footage.
Girls. Wait, did you just get your wisdom teeth pulled?
I did.
How you feeling?
Like I just got my wisdom teeth pulled.
In pain?
A little bit.
Did you cry a little bit?
You know, I cried last night because my brother ate one of my popsicles.
That's some very
sensitive. Did you say anything weird on anesthesia?
Apparently, I told my dentist that he had a fetish for pulling people's teeth and that his wife left him because he kept trying to take her teeth.
I'm here with Miles Hagedorn. Miles, what's one word that describes your swim season?
Losing a lot.
Good. If you were to describe your alpine season in one word, what would it be?
Pretty great. I would say that we as a team have improved overall. Although the boys got sixth and the girls got first, it doesn't really matter. We're just focused on states now.
Yeah, it's not a competition.
I know.
Okay.
Well, just between us and North.
Oh, okay. If you were to describe your hockey season in one word, what would it be? Fun.
Hi.
We're here with the legend, Gwen Owen.
Pleased to be here. Thank you.
I have two questions for you, Gwen. First one, if you were to describe your Nordic season in one word, what would it be?
Bad.
If you were to describe the hockey season in one word, what would it be? What was that?
Sensuality.
Sensuality. All right. Hi, Margaret.
Hi.
If you were to describe our basketball season in one word, what would it be?
Stellar.
Leb. Leb. One word to describe Nordic.
Cold.
No, wait, that's a bad word. Enlightening.
Enlightening, okay. I saw you in that TikTok yesterday. Phenomenal. You did such a good job. We can insert that one.
Baby.
dipping in it.
In more recent news events around the school, we have Ashlyn Feely interviewing Parker Harnett about the recent social justice club that is starting. Pretty interesting stuff. Let's go take a look.
I'm here with Parker Harnett from the Literature and Social Justice Club. So, Parker, what is the Literature and Social Justice Club?
Okay, so I took the class, Literature and Social Justice. You were in it with me. And we read some books and talked about important social issues in today's time. And one of like the things that we focused on was discussions. And we thought that was really beneficial to like our understanding of the issue. So we decided to make a club, and we're going to watch movies and have a discussion about, like I said, like important issues that exist.
When will the first meeting be?
March 19th, we're hoping. I'm not sure it's completely scheduled, but it'll be in the library.
Very cool. What is the goal of the club?
Our goal is to spark change and have discussions that make people think about issues that are important.
Sweet. Back to you.
In the spirit of Valentine's Day, we ended up sending Ode out to talk to the red, hot, and bothered student body.
Let's see what he had to say.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, yo, that's my girl, Gay Drip, right there. Hey.
I'm good. How are you?
Do you want some love advice?
I'd love some, actually. Thank you.
All right, like,
how to get a companion.
Just shoot your shot, bro. That's all it takes. That's all you got to do. You just got to go up to them, be confident, and say, hey, you want to be my Valentine? That's it. Look them right in the eyes. That's it. You want some chocolate? Go ahead.
I got it. Let's go. Thank you.
Look at that, folks. A miracle. A miracle. You want some love advice?
Yes, please.
All right. Here's some good advice. Be kind. And make eye contact. I feel like that's important.
Yeah. I mean, I have a dilemma.
Tell me.
So I'm really nervous. I want to ask my Valentine out on Friday. Her name's Adriana Whitlock, and I don't know if she's going to say yes. What do I do?
Just ask. What's the worst that's going to happen? Like, in 2 years, you're just never going to see anyone ever again, so it doesn't really matter.
So wise. Thank you very much.
Yeah, just shoot your shot. That's all you got to do.
Sweet.
Give her a little win. Okay. Fine.
Ready, catch.
Hey. All right, I'll be right over.
It was like a bullet. Right.
So, you want some love advice? Well, I always got something. So,
yeah, just tell me what's in the pocket of
you. You just gotta be confident, and you just gotta like act like you own the place. Really, you gotta make eye contact when you're asking them. You can't be nervous and jittery, cause that's just like, it's bad. It's a bad look. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
All right.
So as we all know, Valentine's Day is upon us. Who is your Valentine, Audrey?
Adriana Whitlock. Easy. Who's your Valentine?
Whatever girl can dunk a basketball. 10-foot rim. You're mine.
Wow. You know, that's a good answer, Isaac. We should hear what the student body has to say.
Keely, who's your Valentine?
You might know him. His name is Justin Whitlock. Justin Whitlock.
Justin Whitlock.
Justin Whitlock.
You already did that.
Hannah Dwyer. We're here with Hannah Dwyer. Who's your Valentine?
That's a good question. I'm trying to remember.
No worries.
Catherine's my Valentine.
Glessner?
Yeah. It's definitely my second Valentine.
I definitely agree with that statement.
Who's your Valentine?
My Valentine is you, Adriana Whitlock.
Who's your Valentine?
Mandy Jenkins. And I'm your host.
Who's your Valentine?
Ooh. My Valentine is this guy right here.
Yeah.
My Valentine.
Good. I think we got it.
Yeah, I think it was a good episode.
Okay, I can take it.
Oh, wait, hold on. Try this.
Thank you.
Okay. See you, Audrey. Yep.